What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? It has been a long, long time since I have filmed a video for you in this gym. This week, Governor Cuomo finally took his head out of his ass and decided that gyms would be open again. So Monday was the first day the gym was open. I didn't bring my camera on Monday or yesterday, but training's going pretty well. Hit a 512 bench on Monday, hit a 496 tempo bench yesterday. I don't really see any signs of stopping. Bench feels phenomenal. We'll get into all that later, but I'm happy to be back in the gym. I'm happy to be back recording videos for you guys. And one of the things that I want to do for you guys is I want to give you the opportunity, the challenge. If you have no program to follow, and you're just bored with training, I am going to be posting all of my workouts at the beginning of all of these videos. And I'll give you the week in advance, and I'll let you guys follow along with me. I'll explain why I'm doing everything that I'm doing. I will clarify that this is my programming. It probably, for many people, doesn't make too much sense to follow. However, if you're interested in doing so, I'm gonna be posting everything before the week starts, and I will be explaining why I'm doing everything, and then obviously you guys will be seeing my training. So today is not the start of the week. Next week will be. It's a nice little intensity deload next week. So if any of you do care to follow along, you'll be able to ease into it. But also, I need it because I'm smoked after these past 6 weeks. Been working really hard since the meet. You guys have obviously seen that when I was down in Miami. But today, we have tempo squats, we have regular bench press, and we have high rep deadlifts. You guys know how I feel about high rep deadlifts. Alright, this is so bad because I know that next week I'm deloading anyway, but like, holy shit, today is this horrific, horrible first day back to show you guys. I am literally doing my sets of 10 right now with 375, and it's not because I feel weak, but it's because of this rhomboid upper, you know, mid-rib sort of pain right now in the back. This happens from time to time. It hasn't been this bad in a long time. Like, it'll usually flare up and then kind of go away, but today it's really sticking. So I'm just doing what I can movement wise. Friday will be way better. It's weird too because like not only like fatigue trends have been consistent, but also this pain, like every midweek session, the Wednesday, it hurts way more to pull, but then by Friday it's fine, even though, you know, practically I get less rest for Friday's session than I do for Wednesday's because I don't pull on Monday. But yeah, I'm gonna do this pathetic set, show you guys for no reason, and then I'm gonna move on to bench. We're taking it easy the rest of the day. I'm literally gonna show you one set of bench right now. It's 374 for a triple. Literally non-registerable RPE, but I'm just gonna hit it. Get today over with. Progress into tomorrow. The good stuff. Today might be the worst training session I've had in like 2 weeks.
Really? What
the hell happened? Well, let's pretend today didn't happen. On to the next day, Friday. See you guys there.
Full bombs.
So I'm decently happy with that squat single. It's definitely better than last week's. This week's volume was higher than the previous, and that week was higher than the baseline for the block. So given that acute fatigue theoretically should be higher, means that adaptations are taking place for today to have felt as solid as it did. So squats were solid today. No complaints there. I know that once I reset intensity, the next block I'll be able to push even more. And then after that block, we'll shift into competition specific stuff on the top end, because everything on the top end has been tempo lately. Bench today, I didn't show you guys. took it a little easy because I'm trying to do something really, really big tomorrow, so you guys will see that. And then deadlifts right now, top set of 8. We'll see what we got. I feel pretty solid, unlike Wednesday where my back was just fucking killing me, so I'm gonna go warm up now. Deadlifts today are not happening. I'm in a lot of pain, but I know that this is not a damage issue, which I think people need to realize when it comes to feeling pain when they're lifting. Unless you actually have an accident, it is unlikely most of the time that your pain is actually some sort of structural damage. This has happened to me before, not this bad in a really long time. The last time it was this bad was the Arnold 2018, where my Fridays I had to just pull singles and drop them from the top because of how much they hurt. But it's because of the posterior compression on the back of that rib cage from benching, from squatting, and even from deadlifting because of the depression that I'm trying to get in the scaps. I'm not getting air back there, and it's causing a lot of pain. So one of the things that I've always talked about with you guys are like those, that concept of like the mainstay exercises that aid in your performance and aid in movement variability. And in my case, those Monday conventionals, which I haven't been doing, I don't know why I got rid of them again, but they're coming back on Monday at the start of the new block. Because the thing is, with this posterior compression at the back of the rib cage, it's unlike a squat or a hinge movement with regards to like movement variability. It's hard to load a reach, right? Like when you squat or are trying to increase movement variability with a squat pattern, you could use an SSB, you can use a Zercher, you can use goblets, elevate the heels. Same thing with a deadlift. You can do RDLs, toes elevated, heels elevated, use dumbbell, like whatever, right? There's ways to progressively load it for whatever your demands are, right? The stronger you are, the more you're gonna need to load these variable movements for them to have the effect that you want them to, because the adaptation needs to be stronger than the compensatory mechanism that you're utilizing. But with a reach, you can only really use like bands or body weight, and it's hard to actually load it enough to make a difference. Like I've been doing all this body weight reaching and it's not really doing much. But what will continue to help, which honestly, poor judgment to not keep it in, are those Monday stiff leg, really protracted scapula deadlifts, because it's actively integrating you know, the rib cage and pelvis through this hinging movement while actually getting posterior expansion, because I'm reaching in this bottom position, getting the scaps protracted flush around the back of the rib cage and getting airflow back there and continuing through the movement with that same orientation. So I need to bring that back. So that's what I'm gonna do now. It honestly, like doing these super protracted conventional deadlifts don't hurt at all, but when I go to sumo, it does. So I'm gonna reintroduce them, and I'm suspecting that after a couple weeks, the sumo deadlift pain will go away. My theory was right. Those conventional deadlifts actually provided crazy relief. Sam, it's not food, don't worry. Provided really good relief. So those are coming back to Mondays and things should feel better. So I'm gonna head out now. Tomorrow, belt squats and a heavy bench. We'll see you guys then. Fuck you, Nick. What is going on, guys? It is Saturday at United. I don't know about you guys, but I love when the gym is hot. I hate when the gym is air conditioned. Like, I don't know if some of you guys probably watching this have played sports in your life and you had like team workouts, there was no AC, you're in like a sweaty school gym or just like a strength conditioning warehouse and it was just hot as hell. I prefer that. It makes me feel like I'm actually training. But when I have these high rep belt squats, it's rough. But we're gonna try to MRAP this today. So I have sets of 8, which is significantly above what I was doing a few weeks back, and I know that it contributes very well to my squat. I'm just gonna focus up for this set of belt squats. I honestly am more excited to do belt squats on any given day than actual squatting. Squatting sucks. Right, X? Squatting sucks?
I fucking hate squats.
I fucking hate squatting too.
Yep. Nice, Sean. Come on, Sean, let's go! That's easy, man, let's go. Come on. Got at least two more, let's go.
Nope. Listen, Sean, not everything has to make sense.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, so that concludes this last week of the block and the first week of me back at United, the second video of this series. Now the gym's finally open again, I can actually start making videos again for you guys. But yeah, I'm excited. Next week starts the program. Like I said, you guys can follow along. Now you guys know what I can hit on bench press without an arch. If I train it, it'll go up more, I promise you that. So I just wanted to see what I could do. That felt not horrible. But yeah, I'm heading out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, a reminder, by the time this video is up, you guys should be awaiting an email from our team if you applied to be working with one of our coaches starting tomorrow. So today's Saturday, you'll see the video Sunday. So a couple hours after this video gets posted, you guys should be getting something. So don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. Remember, there are no bad days. My mask just came down, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.